Around like this, they'll be back any minute.
Yeah, come on, mate, hurry up. Of course. There it is. I found it.
Where?
Up there. The figurehead from Drake's ship.
Gotta use the silencers.
It's a trap! They're here! Take cover!
God! That's right! We went to Arabia!
Hey, we could use a little help here!
Come on, mate, let's go!
What the hell are you doing?
Grab the journal and the cipher disk!
Got it! Go! We're running out of ammo! Grab the weapon! Everywhere. Come on! We gotta keep moving!
What the hell? This place is growing with them!
everywhere.
Come on! We've got to keep moving! Shit, you're everywhere. Come on, we gotta keep moving. Shit, they're everywhere. Come on, we gotta keep moving. They're everywhere. Come on! We gotta keep moving! Everywhere.
Okay.
Watch it, Nate. This place is crawling with them.
Alright. So far, so good. Playing like shit there for a minute, but whatever. Someone actually told me on Facebook to actually skip part 3. But so far, the actual gunplay is the best out of the series so far. Excuse me. What I mean by that is the guns actually feel like guns. They don't feel like it's hard to describe. They just feel like they got more of a kick to them than part 1 and part 2. Well, maybe not. Oh my god.
Carter, where the hell are we?
It's the North Atwood Station. Come on.
As expected, the gameplay is definitely superior. And this is all leading up to Uncharted 4. Oh shit. What the fuck? Probably the most awkward exchange there I've ever had.
Chloe, can you read me? We're coming out the old North Outlet station. There's no time to
what I'm thinking about with the guns is that they got the physics down to. Oh shit. What the fuck? They actually got the gun physics down. Feels really good. Cover fixes. The cover, getting in cover feels kind of weird. It's like the game, it tries to automatically get you and to let you slide in the cover. Like, I swear to God, see, like, I just put circle there, and it tried to send me over to that little crate, and I have no idea why.
Right, look out. Hurry!
Oh, shit.
Says, well, you better tickle mine too, because now I gotta catch the goddamn thing.
Cheers.
Oh, Scully, and your quips.
Yeah. Are you going to join us, darling?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, the map proves it. Drake didn't screw around in the East Indies for 6 months. He sailed straight through and headed to Arabia.
Right.
Here's where it gets interesting. You see this mark? This is John D's signature.
The hell's John D?
John D, one of Queen Elizabeth's closest advisors.
Everybody knows that.
Yeah, yeah, he was a great mathematician and navigator. And way ahead of his time, he's probably the one who invented that.
Seriously into the occult. I mean, like a really creepy dog.
Yeah, see,
way.
He signed all his letters to the Queen with this symbol, meaning he was her eyes.
The original 007, you see, look, 007.
Not really that relevant.
So it was John D who sent Drake to Arabia.
Yeah, it looks that way. D and Elizabeth.
And Walsingham. Great, but what for?
Well, that's the million-dollar question, isn't it? And this is where T.E. Lawrence comes in. See, before Lawrence became Lawrence of Arabia...
Great film.
He was an archaeologist. And when he was just a kid, he was obsessed with history. Everything to do with knights and crusades. And he traveled all over, documenting every crusader site he could find. It's all in here.
All right, you lost me completely, kid. What the hell has this got to do with Drake?
I'm getting to that. See, after the war, Lawrence said that if he were ever to go back to Arabia... it would be to search for this place he called the Atlantis of the Sands. Now, the legend crops up over and over again under different names. Ubar, Aram of the Pillars, the City of Brass. But the story is always the same.
Well, City of Immeasurable Wealth, destroyed by God for its arrogance, swallowed forever in the sands of the Rubel Kali Desert.
Right here.
I like the immeasurable wealth part, anyway.
And you think this is what Elizabeth and Dee sent Drake after?
Oh, yeah. But more importantly, it's what Marlowe is after.
So, wait. If Drake was on a mission from the Queen to find this place, why all the secrecy? I mean, it looks like he went to a lot of trouble to hide whatever he found, even from Her Majesty.
I don't know.
Oh, I'm sorry, what was that?
No, hang on a second, because if you recall the last time we went halfway around the world searching for a lost city, things got more than a little dicey.
This time we have the upper hand. I mean, look, Drake only had half the clues. Lawrence only had half. We have both. And Marlowe has nothing.
Small problem. The Rubel Kali Desert, 600 miles across. The Bedouin go around the damn thing.
And even if we knew where it was, which we don't, we would die trying to find
just
it.
Just hold on. You see these symbols here?
Yeah. Looks like Sabaean script.
Sabaean script. Right. Look, the Crusaders were searching for the same lost city 1,000 years ago. But out of all the sites Lawrence documented, only two are marked with these symbols. One in Syria, the other in France.
France.
No, you two are going to Syria. We're heading to France. Look, we track down these clues. We find Lawrence's lost city. I'm sure of it.
Well, and then what? How are we going to get across 600 miles of impassable wasteland?
Well, it's in the middle of the desert. So technically, it'd be about 300 miles. Look, I don't know. We'll figure it out.
We burn that bridge when we get to it, eh?
Exactly. What do you say?
What the hell?
C'est la vie.
Let's do it.
Oui. Eastern France.
End of the line, I guess. Don't. Looks like we're going the rest of the way on foot.
PS3 graphics. What? Yeah, that looks so funny.
Leave it to you to find a friggin' jungle in the middle of France.
Well, we're definitely headed in the right direction. Chateau should be this way. Not too far. Come on.
Yeah. Here we go.
Not too far? With you, I never know if that means a quarter mile or 20. Like that time you got us lost in Peru?
Oh, you really want to bring up Peru?
You are not still holding that over me.
I was 15, Sully. Should have known when I met you that I'd be in prison within a year.
You were headed that way all on your own, if you recall. Besides, I got you out, didn't I? Always get you out.
I take that back. The PS3 graphics aren't... Or the remastered version of this is not too bad. Probably gonna have to stop because audio keeps cutting out for some reason. I'm not sure. Move the hell out of the way, son. Yeah. Have to go back to being silent.
Come on, through here.
Audio seems to be cutting out, which is weird.
Just like in Lawrence's notes. Gotta have more faith in me, Sully.
See you guys.
I don't remember this ravine being on the map.
Ah, they must have just put that in.
All right. Come on, we'll find another way around. This way. Watch your step.
Whew. I don't know, kid. You sure we're in the right place? This doesn't seem old enough to be a Crusader castle. It's more like Renaissance to me.
You haven't been reading my books again, have you, Sully? Now, Lawrence says the original castle was built in the 11th century. The rest was added on later. Oh, this looks sketchy. Ah, what are you waiting for? I loosened it up for you.
Yeah, that's the problem.
Look, Sully, your first car.
Oh, man. That's a 1927 Auburn.
Yeah? What's this, Mr. Wizard?
Lawn art.
Pretty tacky. Now, the knight who owned this castle, Lord Godfrey, returned from the Crusades in the 12th century. According to Lawrence, all that's left of the original castle is the square keep and the gardens. If Godfrey brought any secrets back from Arabia, that's where we're gonna find him.
Try this door.
It's no good?
Not getting in this way. About that window above you.
I don't want to cut myself.
All right, nice going, kid.
Be right back.
I'll be waiting.
All right, back up. I'll shoot the lock off.
Make sure that's the only thing you shoot off.
I said lock. You good? Okay. We gotta make our way through the chateau to the gardens. That's where we'll find the old keep.
Oh man, look at this place.
Yeah, we gotta get some leverage.
Think you can get up there?
I can try.
Hey, help me lift this up. Do it. Be careful up there. Old damn thing's rotten.
Looks like those chandeliers are on some kind of pulley system.
Yeah. Must be how they lowered them down to clean them.
I have an idea.
That thing's coming out of the ceiling.
All right, here we go.
What?
Is that a popcorn machine? Okay, let's see if we can find a way to that tower.